Hello friends, we are discussing our module 2, that is ecology. Today I am going to discuss a very key point, very hot spot topic, that is pioneer community versus climax community. Okay, as you can see in this figure, primary succession means pioneer species, then intermediate species and finally climax community. So primary succession, bare rock, lichens, small annual plants and lichens, grasses and perennials, shrubs and shade intolerant trees such as pines, shade tolerant trees such as oak and hickory. Okay, yes. So first topic of discussion is ecological succession. What actually succession means? So succession, it is a natural process by which some community is colonized by different community over a time period. Means one locality, it is colonized by different community over a time period. Or you can say in ecological succession, there will be shifting of community from one to another. Here, succession, the process by which species structure of an ecological community changes over time, it is called ecological succession. Primary succession and secondary succession. So succession, what is the key point of succession? So many factors are responsible for the succession. Some internal as well as external factors are also responsible. So internal factors may be community themselves, which lead to change in environmental condition. Internal factors, they are also known as autogenic factor. Some external factors are also there, which changes the environmental condition. They are known as allogenic. So succession, it is a unidirectional process always. Never be bidirectional. It is always unidirectional, means in one direction. Disturbance can back serial stage of succession. Succession may occur in very long time or short time. Succession, it may be either primary or secondary succession. So primary succession is the succession that begins in an area where the soil has not yet formed, where the barren land is there. Example of event that precede primary succession would be the formation of new island by volcanic eruptions or the retreat of glacier. Secondary succession is the succession that begins after an event clear the community but leave the soil intact. Okay. Means in primary succession, succession start from primary substrate that is free from living organism. What about secondary succession? There will be recolonization of the community. For example, events that precede secondary succession would be wildfires and deforestation by clear cutting. Because the soil is intact, when secondary succession begins, it often progresses much faster than primary succession. And in fact, certain type of natural events such as wildfires, floods and that can add nutrient to the soil. So you can say that the rate of succession, in which type of succession rate will be more? So rate of succession will be more in secondary succession due to rich in nutrients or organic compounds, you can say. Okay. So this is a chart. Comparative chart between the primary succession and secondary succession begins with no life, as I already told you, where there will be no soil. Follows removal of existing biota. Basically, in secondary succession, there will be recolonization of the community. Primary succession, no soil is present. Secondary succession, soil already present. Primary succession, new area, volcanic island. And secondary succession, old area, following a bush fire. Primary succession, lichens and moss come first. Secondary succession, seeds and root already present. Here, biomass is low, biomass is high. Yes, this is also a diagrammatic chart in which you can easily understand. The primary succession, that is the establishment of new community where no one existed before. Okay, starting from water, you can say, pioneer community. So, bare rock is exposed due to some type of disturbance like retreating glacier or volcanic eruptions. No soil is present. Primary species, pioneer species like lichens and mosses establish themselves on the rock substrate. Pioneer species die and decay, providing soil and nutrient for other plant species like shrubs and small trees. Small and large trees begin to grow and the community reaches an equilibrium or the balance. This results in the climax community. So this is the chart from pioneer species to climax community. So primary succession is the establishment of community where there is no existence. Secondary succession means recolonization or re-establishment, you can say, of the community following disturbance. Organisms are driven away by or killed by some type of disturbance. Pioneer species, some pioneer species die and replaced by outcompeted by other species like shrubs and small trees. Small and large trees begin to grow and the community reaches an equilibrium or balance. This results in climax community. Yes. Primary succession versus secondary succession. So, occurs on the surface where there is no soil, colonization of new sites by a community of organism called pioneer species. So, you can write this flowchart, rocks, lichens, moss, grasses, shrubs or trees. Secondary succession occurs when a disturbance of some kind changes in existing community without removing the soil. It takes less time than the primary succession because soil is already present. Disturbance include wildfire, storm, deforestation, farming means soil, grasses, shrubs and then trees. Okay, you can easily see there is barren land, you can say. Soil is not fully prepared. Here there is earlier some community replaced. So, pioneer community, it is the first biotic community which develops in bare area. Pioneer community is established over previously bare area. It consists of fewer small size organism. Area is hostile to pioneer community. This community consists of hardy organisms. Lifespan of organism is also short. Growth is fast, soon replaced by next serial community. So, if we talk about succession process in hydrosphere, it starts from phytoplankton, including blue-green algae, green algae, diatoms and floating organisms. And in between, there will be serial community, that is the rooted submerged stage, that is the hydrilla, rooted floated stage, woodland stage, you can see, and then finally climax community, that is the mesophytes. So, serial stage, what actually serial stages are? Serial community here is the word. So, serial stages, simplest food chain. They follow simplest food chain. They are few and generalized niche. Low energy use, efficiency. Now, it is the climax community. It is a final biotic community that develops in an area. Climax community occur over an area. which is previously occupied by several communities. Climax community consists of large and small sized organisms. The area is favorable to the climax community. The community consists of normal or non-hardy organisms. The lifespan is generally long. So this is the climax community, hydrosphere, xerosphere, physical environment. So, pioneer stage, submerged, floating, reed swamp, marsh meadow, woodland. This is the serial stages. And what about xerosphere? Xerosphere. Crustose lichen stage, that is the pioneer stage. Then foliose lichen, then moss stage, herbaceous stage and then shrubs. So, this is the diagrammatic representation of different developmental stages of the plant succession during hydrosphere and xerosphere, leading to the formation of mesophytic climax forest community. Yes, this chart is too much important. Yes, pioneer community versus climax community. In pioneer community, environment will be unfavorable, but in climax, favorable environmental conditions. Here, pioneer biomass increases quickly. In climax, biomass will be generally stable. Here energy consumption is inefficient. But in climax, energy consumption will be efficient. There will be nutrient loss in pioneer community. But in climax community, nutrient cycling and recycling occurs. They follow R selected strategy. As I earlier told you, what are R and K selected species? Climax community, they follow K strategy. Low species diversity, habitat diversity, and genetic diversity. Means species diversity is also low. Species diversity you can easily understand. Habitat diversity, that is the address, and genetic diversity, that is all are low in pioneer species because they are following R selected strategy. What about climax community? High species diversity, habitat diversity, and genetic diversity. There are so many differences which you can continue in this table. I am going to tell. That is the productivity. If we are talking about productivity, so in pioneer community, productivity means you can say total productivity, it will be less. But in climax community, total productivity will be more. If we are talking about productivity per respiration, so productivity per respiration here will be more because they are respiring less and productivity is more. Means here decreasing trend will follow. What about total productivity? Increasing trend. As we go from pioneer to climax community, there will be total productivity increasing trend. And what about productivity per respiration? Decreasing trend. Productivity per biomass? Increasing trend. No, not increasing. It will also be decreasing. Because productivity per biomass. Here the biomass is low, but productivity is high. So here will be more, here will be less. It will be followed downtrend. And what about NPP? NPP here will be more and here will be less. Okay, nutrient cycling here will be open, here will be closed. What about species richness? Climax, it will increase, means increasing trend, uptrend you can say. And what about seed longevity? If we are talking about seed longevity, so it will also increase. Okay, biotic potential, here will be high, here will be low. High clutch size. Okay. And what about entropy? That is the randomness. Here will be more, here will be less. Climax, it will be less. So stability, here will be less, here will be more. Lifespan, here is short, here is long. Generation time, short, long. Resistance, increasing trend will follow. Okay, uptrend will follow. Means here will, they are having more resistance. And what about resilience property? They are having less resilience property and more resilience. Mean downtrend it will follow. So growth curve, this will be exponential and this will be logistic. Vertical stratification, it will also follow uptrend. Survivorship curve, they follow type 3 survivorship curve and they follow type 1 survivorship curve. If we are talking about resource utilization, they are having high utilization power, fast, or here it will be slow. Seed size, small seed size, but number will be more. Here large seed size, but number will be less. If we are talking about seed viability, I think seed viability you all know, that is the number of seed or the capable of germination. Or the seeds which are capable of germination, so it will also follow uptrend. Means as we are going from pioneer to climax community or succession, seed viability will also increase. We are talking about light saturation intensity. Here it will be high, here will be low. Photosynthetic rate, more, less. And here will be respiration rate, long and short. So at last we can say that seed dispersion is also by wind, by animals. Efficiency to low light, low, and here will be high. So at last we can say that what factors which are increasing as we going from pioneer to climax. So I am telling you in detail. You can write in your notebook or your sheet, right, or your scribble pad, the increasing trend, the uptrend. Okay, if we are going from pioneer, coming from pioneer to climax and going up to climax, so productivity will increase, size will increase, biomass per energy will